Graphene was discovered in 2004. Most of you have probably heard the story, but for any of you that haven't, it's worth sharing. At the time, scientists knew that the one atom thick, two-dimensional crystal graphene existed, but no one had worked out how to extract it from graphite. Two scientists, Andrei Gaim and Konstantin Novoselov, would hold Friday night experiments where they would test new science not linked to their day jobs. One Friday, they removed some flakes from a lump of bulk graphite while polishing it with Scotch tape. They noticed some flakes were thinner than others, and so they continued to separate the graphite fragments repeatedly, which is how they ended up creating flakes that were just one atom thick. They then dissolved the tape away, resulting in graphene being isolated for the very first time. Konstantin and Andrei went on to win the 2010 Nobel Physics Prize for their discovery, as scientists have theorized about graphene for decades. And yes, had any of us playfully put tape on our graphite pencils in elementary school, we could have discovered graphene. Graphene is an allotrope in the form of a single layer of atoms, one atom thick, arranged in a two-dimensional hexagonal lattice. An allotrope is just a structural modification of an element with the atoms bonded together differently. In this case, the arrangement of atoms was modified from three dimensions to two. Graphene is composed of carbon atoms in which each atom forms a vertex, just a point where two or more lines meet. This single layer of atoms is perfectly visible to the naked eye. It has a unique property of expanding when cooled and shrinking when warm. Graphene is literally one of the most mind-boggling discoveries known to man. It is the thinnest material ever discovered while also being the strongest material ever tested, and it can stretch up to 25% of its length. It's 200 times stronger than steel and 40 times stronger than diamonds while being one atom thick. It's bulletproof when folded to two atoms. It's the most efficient conductor known to man. It could hold energy density 6 times higher than copper. It has the best thermal conductivity and is the most impermeable material ever discovered while being bendable and very flexible. It's lightweight and can be added to almost any cell without affecting the cell attributes. This means we may see a world with graphene-enhanced batteries first, as simply adding one layer could result in significant performance enhancements. Graphene could cover both the cathode and the anode, resulting in charge times 5 times faster than currently possible. Graphene suppresses damaging reactions from continuous charging and is even more impressive with rapid C rates of up to 5C. Normal batteries would degrade quickly at these quick charging speeds, as lithium doesn't like a lot of energy in or out. Clearly, the hype around graphene is warranted. It has truly mind-blowing potential in the battery world, and even more use cases in a shocking number of other industries. It's quite possibly the most amazing material known to man. All this being said, it's been joked about that graphene can do everything but leave the lab. So where are we today? There are many companies falsely advertising graphene products. They're actually using graphite, the 3D cousin, without the main benefits of graphene. However, there are true graphene-enhanced products on the market. Before mentioning them, it should be noted that the industry is very convoluted with marketing fluff and hyperbole, as there are literally billions of dollars at stake for the first companies to commercialize this incredible material. Graphene can revolutionize a shocking number of industries. Rust-free ships and cars, computers, phones and foldable screens, aircrafts, aviation, sporting equipment like tennis rackets and skis, night vision contacts, clean drinking water, and many more. Currently, wheel producer Vittoria sells cycling wheels, Anker's audio brand Zolo sells graphene-enhanced wireless headphones, Applied Graphene Materials supplied graphene for use in fishing rods, and Colmar, a high-end sportswear company, sells ski jackets with graphene to enable the fabric to act as a filter between the body and the environment, ensuring ideal temperatures. This only scratches the surface of graphene-enhanced products, but let's get back to the battery world and Tesla. There are a handful of startup companies claiming to have created power banks enhanced with graphene. Apollo Traveler, Real Graphene, Charge A Sap, and Ultron, to name a few. One of the main issues that has held graphene products back has been very high costs. Since one sheet of graphene 1 millimeter thick, or 1/32 of an inch, requires 3 million layers of atoms, graphene has been cost prohibitive to produce in large amounts. In 2013, it was reported that 1 micrometer of graphene, which is 1,000 times smaller than 1 millimeter, cost $1,000, making graphene one of the most expensive materials on Earth. Scientists have been on a frantic search for the holy grail of a scalable production process ever since, and they've made significant strides. It's been reported that in the last 3 years, the cost of graphene is down to 10 cents per gram in some cases. I just purchased the 10,000 milliamp hour Real Graphene power bank. I'll do some real world testing and incorporate it into a video soon to see what sort of practical benefits one of the world's first graphene products can produce. So now the $1 billion question, what does this mean for Tesla? For starters, we need to talk about the Indiegogo campaign hosted by Charge A Sap that is raising money for their power bank called Flash. They make some bold and super exciting claims, but the most interesting and controversial is that this power bank is powered by Tesla graphene batteries. They claim to be using 4 of the 2170 Tesla lithium polymer graphene composite battery cells, which have been specially designed in partnership with Panasonic, who has been making the cells, which they claim are the highest energy density batteries in the world. But here's a potential glaring red flag, among others. They say, quote, "This is the same battery technology found in the latest Tesla cars, which is how Tesla cars are able to charge so fast and have such long-lasting batteries," end quote. Not only is this an incredibly generic statement, but we have not heard anything from Tesla about a 2170 graphene composite cell already being used in their cars. Speaking of red flags, the company Charge A Sap is reportedly headquartered in Los Angeles, but when you go to their Indiegogo business page, it says they are in Sydney, Australia. They set a fixed goal of $5,000, which is wildly small for a technology like this if it were real, and they have apparently raised $663,000 for a project that's only in the prototype stage. There were numerous errors throughout the sales funnel paired with vague wording which can often scream scam alert. The question needs to be asked, would we really see a seismic shift in battery tech from an Indiegogo crowdfunding campaign with no mention of this from Tesla or Panasonic? If you're not familiar with Indiegogo, this could just as easily be a front for a money laundering scheme. However, they have delivered on 5 of their 7 total crowdfunding projects. What value you choose to give that, I'll leave up to you. Of course, I would love nothing more than for Tesla and Panasonic to be working together to be producing and testing graphene composite batteries. While I can't argue that it's likely that this is what they're doing, it's certainly possible. You never know who knows who at these companies, and it would in theory be a good way for Tesla to dabble with graphene in the real world and begin testing the reliability, performance enhancements, and cost efficiencies that could be available before then implementing on a larger scale in their EV cells. While I won't be holding my breath, it's something we should all be following closely. I wish there was a stronger link between Tesla and graphene technology to report, but there is 0% chance that Tesla has not been experimenting and paying attention to the graphene advancements. It's been the wonder material of the 21st century, and Tesla, being the world leader in EV battery tech and production, will be ready and waiting in the wings if and when graphene is ready to be mass-produced and implemented in EV batteries in a cost-effective fashion. If Elon does not mention graphene in April at Battery Investor Day, we need to get a shareholder to ask him directly about Tesla's plans and thoughts on graphene. If you'd like to help ensure this happens, feel free to share this video by any means you're comfortable with, so we can increase the chances of learning more about Tesla's true thoughts on graphene. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this and have learned something new. Feel free to subscribe if you'd like. We'd love to have you with us. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day.